check the mic and make sure it sound right, boys.
All right, hello, bonjour and namaste. This is Mr. Brown and welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys have already seen my previous videos. If you have not, I'll put the link somewhere in the top. So please go and watch it out. And if you haven't subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe. Today's video is very important actually, because when I woke up in the morning, I just saw. Which means time for our groceries. Today we will be seeing how the German supermarkets looks like. So there are a lot of them actually, which are like Aldi, Netto, Edeka and Lidl also. But they all have their advantages and disadvantages. Without wasting any time, let's just go inside the supermarket. So guys, I'm almost ready actually. So I was just about to head outside and what I noticed suddenly is the weather is super bad. And if I mean super bad, it is super bad. I'll show you guys how it looks like. So from the inside itself, you can see that there is a lot of snow on this window. Let's see what is going on. So you can see it's snowing right now and even with the high wind. So right now the temperature is around -1, but it feels like as -7, and the wind speed is nearby around 12 to 15 kilometers per hour with a 50% humidity in the air. But don't worry, we are not going to stop. Maybe I can show you this kind of a weather today. But before going outside, we have few things which we need to prepare so that we can save a lot of money while we are doing our shopping. So the first thing is a grocery bag or a backpack, whatever you would like to prefer. So if you're not taking a grocery bag with you, you maybe have to pay around 20 cents to 1 euro maybe, depending on the kind of a shop or depending on the kind of a bag which you want. So I always recommend you to take a grocery bag or a backpack with you. The second thing is a very interesting thing, which I think is really cool in Germany. So you can take all of your kind of a cans or kind of a bottles. I think not a glass bottle sometimes, maybe if you drink beer, of course you can take a beer bottle with you. But there are some restrictions which kind of a bottle you can recycle. So whenever you are going for a grocery shopping, take these kinds of a can or anything, because you'll be getting a refund on these bottles. So I think I spent it around 70 to 80 cents on this bottle or on this can, and I'll get around 25 cents back from this can. So here from this little mark, maybe you can see that this is a sign that you will get a fund. So yeah, this is a really good way of saving your money actually when you're going for shopping in Germany. So the last thing is to carry card or cash. In Germany or in any of the European countries, I think you can pay with both of the card or a cash. But my personal recommendation is to always carry a cash whenever you are traveling, because there are a lot of small shops which do not accept card. So in that case, the cash can save you. Another important thing, so if you are the one who is planning to travel to Europe just after the COVID, please check the regulations for shopping, because right now you have to wear a mask while you are going for a shopping. So here is mine, which is a FFP2 mask, and this is a mandatory one which you have to wear. So this is my small logo, just for information, or maybe for branding. Okay, so the weather looks fine now, so maybe without wasting any time, we should start. So guys, you can see that the weather changes so frequently. Just around 10 minutes before it was snowing like hell, but now you can see it's a little bit snow but with a lot of sun. So we are almost, and maybe I can show you from here, is just take a Einkaufswagen, which is like a shopping cart from here, and then you can hand. So here you can see that you can take this wagon for 50 cents for 1 euro or 2 euro. As of now, I think I only have 2 euros, so just plug it in and you have it now. So guys, this is a machine where you have to put your old bottles and you'll get a receipt for money from here. Let's try it out. You just click on fund and we made some amount of money which will be used for the shopping. Make sure you give this receipt at the time of billing. Well, let's just have a quick tour and then we'll go into details. So here you can find all the fresh fruits. This is a complete section for the fruits, and they are really fresh actually, and they have two different categories. One is bio and one is normal, so you can buy any of them if you want. This section is also for buying vegetables. Here is for vegetables now, so you can see the two different categories on the screen there. Maybe I can show you. So they are the bio ones and the normal ones actually. So the next section is for flowers, so you can buy different variety of flowers from here, and they are I think really cool and really cheap. So it's the one thing I have noticed in Germany that everybody uses flowers in their houses. So these are some beautiful ones and the cheap ones, so you can buy them from here. I also would like to highlight that there are two different sections for bread. These are fresh ones, which I would always recommend to buy from. And the next one are the packet ones, which are like here, so you can see. And you already know that German loves bread. So these are the different variety of breads you can buy. These are the sweet ones, sour ones, and all of actually. So sometimes you will see that the fresh ones are cheap actually. So this is a very familiar one, which you might have also seen Pritzel. So you can see the price for it. All of them are the same price, and these are the packed ones. These are a little bit costly. They have a different variety into it actually, so you can buy whatever you prefer. They have a lot of variety here. So this is one of my favorite cake, I would say, from Bailey's. I always recommend you to try this ones. So these are the really big refrigerators in which you can find all the food which you can keep in a fridge. So this is a complete refrigerator actually, and all of the food is really cool here. So you can find curd, milk, cheese, and any kind of a things from this section. If you are lazy to cook and if you want to eat like a healthy food, you can get the packets from the salad here, and you can get some juice from here. And these are all the sandwiches, which is a kind of a ready-made food. You can just warm it up or can eat it just like this. And they're also cheap actually. So if you're lazy, everything looks cheap. So I have these kind of a sections where you can find some extra stuff, which is like 1 euro stuff. I'm also going to make a video on 1 euro shop, which is really cool. And I always recommend you to watch it. And if you are in Europe, just visit them once. You can find a different variety of stuff here. Let's see what we get here. Okay, they are selling things from summer, but actually it's winter. So these are the another refrigerators, the bigger ones, in which you can find all the kind of a Gemüse, means vegetables, and all the kind of a frozen food like pizza or anything like this, or even ice creams. So you can find from these bigger fridges from here. Here is a milk, which is a basic need for everyone. And they have a different kind of a variety actually. So you can get a 3.5 fat milk, or you can get a 1.5. They also have sometimes which is 3.8. I'm not sure where is it, but you can buy the milk from here. And the prices are different based on the different brands. So let me know what is the price in your country now. All of these are variety for the butter actually. But the weird thing which I found in Germany especially is all of these butters are good, but none of them are that salty as we Indians eat. So be prepared for it. Let's head back. This is a fridge where you can find all the kind of meats if you are a non-vegetarian. So this place is for you. So let me show you a price for some of them. Maybe we can catch it from here. Chicken of 3.5. I don't know much about it, so I'm sorry. So now this complete section is for the drinks. So you can find all the kind of beers, all the kind of the juice or the water from here. And if you want to prefer a milk, which is not from a refrigerator, so you can get it from here. the price is almost like similar, I would say. So you can make your choice. You might have already noticed that there are these kind of a crates, so you can take a complete crate and you can return it back. You have to give some kind of a fund when you are taking the complete crate, but when you are returning it, you can just replace it or you can just return it and you get the money back. As you already know that the Germans love beers, so here you can see that they have a lot of a variety of beers, and I personally have tasted most of them, and I would definitely recommend you, if you are traveling to Germany or any of the European country, just try the beers once. So here's the price for the complete crate, which is quite reasonable. Section for wine, as you can see, it's written on the top, so you can buy a different kind of wines from this section. Okay, now let's see some of the basic things which we guys are always using. So I'll head back for my shopping list now. So if you're Indian, definitely you might be having a lot of chai. So this is the milk which I prefer. So let's take it once. I'm also craving for tortillas today, so I'm gonna take some grated cheese from here. This is a special section for me because I'm a vegetarian and I can get all of the kind of vegetables from here. You can see the prices for this, and they are kind of cheap, I would say. It's fine. So yeah, you can head over here if you are a vegetarian. The other thing, when I'm too lazy to cook, I always use these pomace. So let's take one of them from here, and that would save me actually. Important thing for the ladies, you can find all the kind of sanitary stuff from here. You can also check the price, which I think is really cool. And the other important thing is Netto always have this kind of a section which I really love about. So they have some kind of a discounted things from here. I always prefer to have a walk from this section at least once. Another important thing are the tissue rolls, which you might already heard in the news that when the corona hit, everybody was just grabbing like they're gonna eat these papers. So here are some of the prices for this, but I always recommend to use the good one, otherwise you'll be ending up with a lot of rashes. Let's check it out. Isn't this thing cool? So you can just buy this if you're having a party or something. Just blow up all the balloons from the bottle itself and you're done. So here is our cloth washing liquids and the powders. So the prices are also mentioned. The key thing which I'm going to tell you now, also going to tell you guys a little bit hack. Let me check if nobody's watching. So if you see, on the lowest row always is the cheapest price, and on the topest row is the kind of a little bit higher price. Let's see. So you can see this is for around 55 cents. Here it is on 139, and it goes up to 1.59. So this is a different variety of cooking oils, whichever you prefer, and you have all of a kind of a different varieties actually, but what mostly Indians prefer is this one. So the price of the oil is 1.19, and this is a section where you can find all the mayonnaise and different kind of a sauce. This is for the younger generation who don't want to cook, like me of course. So this is a section where you can find all the kind of a soup or a kind of a spaghetti, whatever you would like to prefer. It's from two different brands, I think from Knorr and from Maggi, and they are kind of a cheap. So if you are having a Netflix and chill day, you can make some soup and have some drinks. So this is, I think, a really, really important section if you're coming from India. So this is a section where you can find all the kind of masala. So check out the price, guys. Isn't it ridiculous? So I always recommend you, if you're coming and if you are kind of a spicy guy, just bring all the spices from the India itself, because they are so costly here. You can check out the price here. But the costliest spices is not only other brands, but this is in all over Europe, because people don't prefer to eat spices here, so it's kind of really costly. This is one of my favorite kind of soft drink, I would say. So it's called Radler. So it's a kind of a beer which you can have with a lemon. So it's really cool, and the price is also fine, I think. So I always recommend you, whenever you are traveling to Europe or to Germany, try this out. And of course, if you're in Germany and not taking beer, then you're not in Germany. So here is this rice. They have a different kind of variety. So these are the already cooked ones if you are too lazy, but these are the one which I would always prefer. So I recommend, if you are coming from India, then definitely try these rices. If you are a fan of pasta, then this place is definitely for you. So I always prefer to take a spaghetti from here, which is around 49 cents, and a pesto from here. So this is a thing which I have never tried back in India. So I always recommend you, if you are coming, and try this pesto roll. So this is one of my favorite ones. And if you do own a pet, you can get all the pet food from here. This is also cheap, I would say, not so costly. So you can see the price here. So as I'm all done with my shopping, let's head back to Kase, which is where we go for billing. But I cannot shoot a video there because of security reasons, because there's a lot of cash, of course. So I'll see you guys outside after having my billing. Let's just put the trolley here. You just need to take the next one. Put it in. Get the money back. Alright guys, so we are all done with the shopping and now I'm heading back to my house so that we can discuss or we can review some of the things from my shopping experience. So just give me a minute and I'll be back in the house. Alright, so we are back in the house now after doing a shopping at the supermarket, which is called as Netto. So I would also like to share a kind of my own experience which I have gone through from around like 2 years. So I have been to different supermarkets like Netto, Aldi, Edeka and Lidl, all of them actually, at some different places. So what my recommendation is, or what my experience is, that Netto, Aldi and Lidl are a little bit cheaper as compared to Edeka actually. So whatever I have bought today from Netto costed me around 4 euros I think. So the same thing would have costed me around maybe 7 euros. Depending on the kind of discount they are going on, but I always found that Edeka is much costly as compared to Netto. So if you are a student or if you are coming here on a low salary or something, then always prefer to go to Netto or to Aldi, but of course at the end is your choice, because in Edeka they take money for the service. So whenever you will enter Edeka, you'll be like, oh, I just entered into a mall or something, because they have everything very arranged, everything is very clean, they have a different category for everything, and it's maybe a little bit bigger as compared to Netto and Aldi also. So in Edeka, if you're buying a same packet of a milk, it's not like ke niche se dhua niklega aadmi nikal ke salam karega, aisa kuch bhi nahi hai. It's the same thing, so you can buy it from anywhere you want. About the fund machine, like when you are giving your recycling things back, you get some money received back which you can use, of course, but these machines are almost in all of the supermarkets. So you can take any of the bottles which you have bought from any other supermarket, you can go to any of the machine and you can just put it inside and take your receipt back. So guys, there are also these kind of websites in which you can compare about like what the discount is going on and which supermarket you can prefer for different kind of items. I'll put the link in the description below, so please go and check it out. And if you guys have any question, I have tried to cover most of the things in this market, but if you have any question or any doubt, just write down in the comment section so that I can cover them in my next videos. So depending on the kind of weather, we are also going to create a video which is about transportation in Europe and how you can take your first ticket when you are arriving at the airport. And the interesting part is we are also going to conduct some interviews with the German people and also from the different foreigners and ask them questions about India. So this is going to be really cool. Stay tuned. So I hope you guys have enjoyed my video and I'll see you guys in my next video. Till that time, stay safe and stay healthy. Ciao. It sound right, boy.